Hey, good evening, everybody. I'm here with Midwest Miniature Guy. It's our Sunday night chill stream. Hope you all are doing well. Had a pretty good weekend. Boy, I got some cleaning done last night. Went on a little bit of a manic cleaning deal. I started about, I don't know, 10:45. Didn't get down to like 1:30 this morning. But I just have a ton of crap right back in here, and that's all gone. And I had a ton of crap that was over there, and that's all gone. I had a bunch of stuff in the game room. It was basically just boxes. Like, you know, when I was shipping a lot of minis, I had a bunch of, I would save cardboard boxes, and I'm not shipping a whole lot right now. Most everything is local, so I got one that's coming, I think, from Ohio, but you know, that's only a couple figures. I don't need a box this size for like two little figures. So that all got done. I got rid of some ugly bar chairs that we don't need anymore. Yeah, I'm putting these on because I need to be able to see what we're doing here. But anyway, that is all done. It's all out. Got a new figure yesterday because I want to terrorize my fifth ed group. So I picked up the Zombie Hulk. Gonna be fun to paint him up. Get him all zombified. I also picked up a new contrast paint. It's like the turquoise Games Workshop or Citadel contrast paint. Looking forward to using that maybe as some patinaing on some bronze. Could be fun. I don't know. Give it a shot. But tonight we continue work on the Spidertaur, the adult Spidertaur. We got the babies done last Sunday. We are working on the adult this Sunday. So I'm going to go ahead and get started. Take this. Okay. So I have some ideas. So we got the flesh tone done last Wednesday. And I started putting a little bit of purple into it. I'm glazing that in. But I think I want to add a little bit of blue. So I've got some brilliant blue here. And I kind of want to make it look like it is tired. It's got some dark dark stuff under the eyes. I think this blue will help with that, if I can get it out. There we go, just a little bit. We don't need a whole lot. And we're going to turn this into a glaze. We're going to get quite a bit of water here. My water's kind of gross. Had a friend of mine, I had my friend Molly over last I was going to say yesterday evening, but that's not correct. It was yesterday afternoon. She came over around 1 o'clock, and we worked on a character of hers that she's playing in my 5th Ed game, Corvus, the Kenku Druid. It's actually sitting over here, and because she didn't take it home with her, I think we're going to try and plan another paint day so that she can get it done before our game on the 30th, but we'll see. We're kind of busy, so I hope I can get some time. And if that's not the case, maybe I'll just ask her if she wants me to finish them up, and then I'll do that. But okay, so we've got this fairly transparent. We kind of want it transparent because we're going to be glazing. Hey, Quick, how you doing tonight? It's going pretty good. I'm doing all right. I have not checked emails or Discord messages, so Last day on call. Nice. Well, I wish you well on your last day of on-call work. That is still... I need it more transparent. This is a very opaque paint. I just want... Maybe I need to go for the different one. Nope, there we go. Now I got it. Got it dialed in now. Just when I'm looking. A little tired. They've been looking after those babies. So I'll get that out of the way. You know those little ones, they gotta be fed. So you gotta make sure that they get the choices that survivors coming into attracted to their taunting friend here. So I had a major serotonin boost on Thursday. Matthew Mercer, who is the DM for Critical Role, of course, most of you probably know that, had tweeted out that they were playing Kingdom Death, and he had painted the Phoenix, which I have painted, and the tree, which I'm about to paint. And I mentioned that I had painted the tree, but I had painted the Phoenix, and I was getting ready to work on the tree. And I said, but I'd got the babies done, and I posted that picture. And he actually commented, he says, these are incredible, with incredible in like full caps. And I was like, oh my gosh, hi, he saw this, that's pretty cool. Not that I'm overly fanboying, but it was neat. It was cool to be acknowledged by someone with his following. And as of right now, just the photo that I posted alone has like 197 likes on it, or thumbs up or whatever you want to call it with tweets. It's been retweeted a couple times, and so I'm riding high on a little bit of that serotonin. And it's been going on all weekend. So, like, every time I pop Twitter open, there's something else. Like, either somebody's commented on it or said something. So, as soon as I get this thing done, I'll have to post and tag him and go, all right, so I got the Spider Centaur done. What do you think of this? And, we'll see where it goes from there. But that was pretty cool. It was fun. It's been an interesting interaction. Not a problem, Quick. You have good luck with that call. So I'm going to try and get a little bit of blue in some of these recesses here. Just to vary up the skin. That, if I'm going to be doing yellow in the eyes like I did with the babies, I need a little bit of shadow going on in these. Not so much these, no two on top there, but that's all I'm going to do. It's just a real quick. Come on. There we go. So you can see some of the blue there underneath the eyes and around the main eyes here. I thought I was going to do a little bit more purple, but I'm not. I'm going to leave that alone. Which means we get to go on to our kind of undeady flesh around the green. Shake and paint. It's shake and paint. So we need a good pile of that. Then we need beat up brush. We'll grab this army painter. This is a dry brush anyway, but normally I like it a little bit softer. And this should be okay. We'll be alright. On there. All right, let's see. We've got some rather lovely pustules up there too, so we want to do something kind of cool with those. Its rib cage almost looks like it's made out of fingers too. You can see like little, almost like knuckles on it. It's pretty gross. Pretty gross. Start getting the legs here. Nice thing about some of these smaller pieces here, with these little legs, they just need to run a brush across them when they pick up the paint, so. That's kind of nice. I hate painting spindly things because they always want to bounce around. I'm hitting the frickin' microphone. I'm gonna move it here. There we go. Oh, you folks want some music? I almost forgot about that. Let me see what I can find tonight for us that I can listen to that won't get me DC. give me 1 second here. Wow, I went to go find my friend's YouTube channel because I played drums on his album and it is no longer there. Who is? Good gravy. Well, I guess we're not going to do that then. So, I'm just going to go home. Sorry, now all you're seeing is my hand moving here. I'm gonna find. Yeah, we'll play this. Sterling, hey, how's it going? Good to see ya. I'm just finding some music to play over here. Stuff that won't get me banned. Stuff from an old band of mine that I used to play in. So I can say, I play the drums on these, you can't take it off. Ah, too bad. Otherwise, doing all right. How about yourself? Cool. Yeah, I play drums. I was in a Christian rock band called the Jordan River Project, which we're listening to right now, and currently playing for a Irish pub rock band called the Serfs. So I've been doing that for 30. Well, I've been playing drums now for over 30 years. I've been with the Serfs now for 14? Question mark? I know our album had its like 13th anniversary, the one and only album that we put out so far. I'm trying to get these knuckleheads to record again. Oh yeah, this is much better. Nice bigger brush. It's timing. For us, it's trying to find the time to go ahead and actually record an album in basically a couple of days. Because when we did it back in 2008, we did literally a month of Sundays. We took all of November, every Sunday in November, and went in and recorded our album, Will Work for Beer. Streaming, you know, you don't have to be here all the time. And that's one nice thing, like, I try to put stuff up on YouTube after I'm done. So I just, actually tonight I uploaded last Sunday's stream. And then tonight I will upload last Wednesday's stream. So you can see how we started. The Spidertaur here. I'm so glad I switched to a bigger brush. Holy cow. Yeah, this thing was gonna take me forever. What kind of, Sterling, what kind of music you like to play? What are you into? So spindly, I just don't want to break it. Oh, cool. You are speaking my language there with Dream Theater and Rush. That's a lot of stuff that I listen to and pretty much cut my teeth on playing when I was a kid. So for sure, I love that stuff. Big prog rock music fan. Yes, Supertramp, Pink Floyd. Buddy Guy is great. Great musician. Government Mule is fun. Yeah, I love Dream Theater. Mike Portnoy and Neil Peart are probably my two favorite drummers in that genre. There are other drummers that I love. Steve Smith from Journey is great. Yeah, if you ever get a chance to actually sit down and listen to Journey and the guitar parts that Neil Sean came up with, they're not just your average pop rock band. It's very intricate, very interesting stuff. I don't fancy myself a guitarist by any means. I play about 3 or 4 chords and I'm good. But as I was getting older and wanting to experience and enjoy the music more, I wasn't just listening to what the drums were doing. I wanted to hear what all of the instruments were doing. So I would sit and listen to one song, like, I don't know, 15, 20 times, and start trying to pick out, oh, what's the bass doing here? What's the keyboards doing? If there were keyboards, you know, what are the guitars doing? Steve Lukather of Toto, fantastic guitar player. Yeah, he's the type of player too that has been on multiple albums, not just, you know, with Toto. So he was a session player for years, and so yeah, just trying to find albums that he has played on is always interesting. Just saw a video. I guess I'd ran across it a few years ago, but then I rediscovered it a couple of days ago. And it was Neil Peart playing a song on Vertical Horizon's album from like 2017. And I was absolutely blown away. I was like, holy cow, I didn't realize he went out and played with other bands. I mean, I guess he had done some work with the Canadian Hockey League. He has a whole drum set that has like hockey logos on it, which I think is super cool. Not that I'm a huge hockey fan, but I just thought that was a very interesting little factoid that, yeah, Peart's out there playing with other people too, not just Rush. Speaking of Rush, I mean, their guitar player is just awesome. Alex Lifeson, he's got a new band coming out, or that's out now too. Definitely not in the same vein as Rush at all. A lot more ambiance type music, still guitar based. But definitely more ambianced. Keyboards. And actually electronic program drums. I don't think they have a drummer listed as playing on that album. So I think they programmed everything, which is kind of sad. Because there's a ton of wonderful drummers out there that would be like, I'll play drums, I'll bring the skins for you. But maybe you didn't want to go that route yet, which is cool. It's fine. Yeah, Alex has some crazy chords. I think one of my favorite Rush songs, and some people might be surprised by this, is I love Red Sector A. The guitar work on that, I think is phenomenal. Yeah, all I can do is just survive. Yep. Yeah, great, great song. Awesome lyrically, just musically in general. Is a great one. Between the Wheels is a good one. But yeah, I mean, I could go on and on and talk about music for hours on end. While we paint here. That's how much of a musical nerd I am. I actually posted a concert on my Facebook page. My personal page, not my MMG page. And my guilty pleasure concert, because it's Great White from 1988. And they were touring in support of like their latest album, which I think was Shot in the Dark. And I didn't find those guys until it was either 88 or 89. Whatever Once Bitten, Twice Shy came out, and God, I was probably 13. Yeah, I think I was 13. I was in 7th grade, and I had never heard anything like it before, because I grew up in Podunkville, Washington State, and that was the band that just kind of caught me. I'd heard, you know, the top 40 station that I could barely get out of Lewiston, Idaho. You know, they would play some Police, and they would play some Cutting Crew and Glass Tiger. You know, stuff like that. But we moved down to Cheyenne, Wyoming, so my stepdad could go to school down there and become an airplane mechanic. And there was a radio station down there. I mean, they played everything, but that was one of the songs that I first heard, and I was like, I gotta find these guys. And then to come to find out there was like four or five other albums before that that goes back to like, you know, 82 or 83, and I was like, okay, well, I guess I'm gonna go for a deep delve here and pick them all up. So, I haven't picked up a Great White album in years, unfortunately, but the last one I did was a kind of a semi-live album that was very good. Had some great players on it. Mark Kendall, actually, is a really great rock guitarist, very heavily based in the blues. So if you haven't gone and listened to some Great White, they're a fun, guilty pleasure hair band, but heavily rooted in the blues and Led Zeppelin. You can hear it in Jack Russell's voice. He is trying to emulate Robert Plant a lot. They actually did an MTV Unplugged. And the version that they did was, they did Babe, I'm Gonna Leave You. And, yeah, heavily influenced by Led Zeppelin. I mean, don't be thrown off by like their album covers and whatever. They are very much a hair metal band of the 80s. But a lot of their songs, you know, besides the ones that made the radio, like Once Bitten, Twice Shy, it's your average blues riff. Bum, 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 ba-dum, ba-dum, bum. It's a blues riff. But some of their other songs are very good. You know, you kind of got to delve into the albums and listen to some of the other ones on there, like Warrant. You know, if I was gonna let's go full 80s hair metal band, Warrant. They had Cherry Pie and what was the other big song that they had? Down Boys and stuff like that, right? Very radio friendly. But if you listen to some of the other songs that are on their albums, it's like they hide these cool little gems of music. You know, just like, you know, like Winger. We'll talk about Winger here for a second. Oh, it's a W song, a W bands. Winger had, you know, She's Only 17, right? But then you listen to the rest of the album, like that was their radio hit. You listen to the rest of their album, and it's like, holy cow, this is some really heavy prog rock stuff, because you had Rod Morgenstein, who was the drummer for the Dixie Dregs, playing on it on all of his albums and touring, and it's good stuff. I think they were very heavily influenced by Rush and Yes and stuff like that, because you know Kip is a great singer. Yep, Blues Traveler, yeah. Yeah, I know, Michael Bolton had a rock band. I had no idea. I had found that out like a couple years ago, and I was like, no way. But, you know, when a man steals a hit song, he can do whatever he wants. I think Steve Morse was in Dixie Dregs, yes. Rod Morgenstein was the drummer. Steve Morse, I think, was the guitar player. I wish I could remember the bass players' names for half these bands. But yeah, check out, you know, yeah, Dixie Dregs. There's so many great musicians out there that have gone and done, you know, commercial stuff, basically. You know, oh, I'm gonna go out and I'm gonna play in this band because they're paying my bills right now. But they go out and, yeah, like you were saying, they have, you know, they have their one or two commercial hits that are gonna get played on the radio for forever, and then they're gonna have those little underground, well, not so much underground hits, but those little, what I would call B-sides, or what people back in the 80s, 70s and 80s would call B-sides. And, you know, they're going to throw on kind of the deeper cut from their album on those. I remember getting cassette tape singles, and it would have the hit on side A, and then they would have, like, side B is this song. And that's how I got into some of these bands, because I was like, oh, I really like that song. This little single cassette is only $3, but I get a second song on the back. And maybe sometimes it's like, oh, it's the demo version of the hit song, right? They're going to put on the B-side demo version of it. But other times it's like, oh, this is kind of like a deep delve into what these musicians can actually do. They're not just going to play three chords and write a little catchy pop song. It's going to be, you know. So yeah, enjoy. Go Okay, I think we got our ghoul skin done here. Maybe at the top real quick, just like so. Creepy. Pretty creepy. But also been getting into jazz. I know, not too many. Who made this? This is Kingdom Death Monster. This is the Spidertaur. And we've gotten the face. We still gotta do the eyes on the face. But he's kind of like an angler spider because he's got this little deal hanging here with a quote unquote human body attached to it. And he dangles it out there to tempt other humans to come and save them. And then he grabs them and eats them himself, or feeds them to their children, who look like these little guys, little creepy guys. But I mean, this thing's big. I mean, compared to a survivor. That's what that looks like. You know, imagine this thing coming at you. Whoa, 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 whoa. Alright, now we're gonna hit it with some moldy skin. Bottle. Even though we're putting on this light coat of this kind of it's undead fleshy color here, I'm gonna add some other colors into it. I might add some purples and maybe another green to it, just to give it a little eerier look. Because now we're gonna go with some bloodless skin. This will be the final little bit on this. Then we can work on some details for the next hour. No, not exclusively. I've used quite a bit of Reaper on it, but I've also used some Citadel contrast paints for the skin and the green. The green is actually like an orc flesh from Citadel. The initial base coat for the flesh tones was Ghulamon flesh contrast paint, and then I used Reaper paints for the rest of the stuff. I'm going to use the tan skin triad for the skin tones. This is the undead skin triad that I'm using for the body. I'm going to use some skeleton horde on the feet and the fingernails. I still got to do the body here too. That's another contrast paint. I'm going to use some tones, maybe some washes or something like that from Army Painter on the body. Don't get me wrong, I love Reaper paints, but there's just some other stuff that I like to try and use. Technique-wise. Sometimes it's just fun to use different stuff. So this is the Citadel color contrast skeleton horde. Now we're going to use this on some of the bone sections, like I said, the feet, the fingernails. There's some bony sections up here on his arms. gonna start with the hands. Hopefully you guys can see this. I want to show it to you here. This is what the contrast paints will do. It's almost like a stain. Like I spilled a little bit of Yandan yellow on my hands yesterday. I have washed my hands several times today, scrubbed them, and I still have yet to get some of that paint off. Like there's a big splotch right there that I just haven't been able to get off my fingers. So that's what that does. I know it's kind of shiny, but it basically stains the, because I just have primer on this, so I'm staining the primer with this contrast. I don't need to let that dry. I'm not going to hit it with a hand dryer. Yep, hit my leg again. These stupid long legs. As you can see, I'm not being super careful. I'm using a size 6 brush because I want to get this done. I don't want to dink around. Use a little tiny brush for this. The other nice thing about the contrast paints is if you think that you haven't put on enough, you can go back in after it dries a little bit and put more on, and it kind of darkens it up a little bit. So that's kind of cool. I never thought that I would like them strictly for painting. You know, just putting this on and then calling it good. Oh, no problem, Steve. No problem, Sterling. All good. never take anybody's silence for as that they're not watching or uninterested. I figure that they are, they're either concentrating on something or they're lurking, which is fine. Just hanging out. Like I said, I want my streams to be a nice, quiet place for people to come on Wednesdays and Sundays and just relax. We're listening to some music, maybe, depending on if I can get it to play, and just kind of hanging out. I'm going to ask my friend Jared if I can stream, if I can use his music on my stream. He's a country artist, grew up here in Minnesota. He's actually one of my wife's friends, went to high school with her, and I'm going to ask him if I can use his music, because I've got some of that on my player here as well, and I've got one of his CDs too, so. See if he wants a little, if he's okay with me using his music on my stream. And I may ask my friend Megan if I can play one of her Irish stories CDs on my stream. Well, maybe not, because I'm talking and then she's talking and we don't want to get that confused. Yeah. So I'm going to add a little bit of this to the quote-unquote hair of the human here. So I want this to be kind of more of a brown blonde look. Sterling, if you ever want to show off what you're working on, I'd love to see it. Throw it up on the Midwest Miniature Guy Discord. I'd love to take a look at it, see what you're painting. If you're comfortable with that. This stuff dries pretty quick. Which is nice. A little bit of this. This is what I was talking about. This is the Eandon yellow. It's more of like an orangey yellow. I'm going to put this in the eyes and then we'll use a lighter yellow, or brighter yellow, I should say, for the highlight. Oh, I should have used that. Oh, wait, already got some stuff on the teeth. Okay, we're good. Yeah, absolutely. Yep, DM me on Twitter or whatever. If I had a moderator, I would love to have them post stuff. I wonder if Quick's a moderator, but I think he's on call right now. So you could post my Discord and Twitter feeds while I continue working on this. Well, that just made it 100 times creepier. Very creepy. Here, I'm gonna turn on this camera here. So I can show you up close what this face looks like. So there's our creepy face with the yellow eyes. I'm going to make a lot more yellow. Because I'm going to use, what's it called here? Flash Gets Yellow is what I'm going to use for the highlighting of the eyes. But there's our back. There's the hands. Yeah, imagine this thing coming at you, and then it's got six of these little monsters with it. So yeah, scary, evil little things. And yes, I agree, they're Australian. They definitely need more monsters and less boobs. Not that I'm opposed to boobs, but, I mean, I'm married a woman. But, if they're going to call a thing Kingdom Death Monster, give us some really nasty looking monsters. I should put some of these, some of this down here. That's more of a, it's not really a pustule. I will have to say that some of their figures, like this one, is actually pretty good. Here, I'm gonna get back to my close-up camera. Like, take a look at her. She's a well-armored figure. And she's not showing boobs. Like, this is full arm, that's like, you know, female boob armor. But she's in full armor. She's not showing any skin except for her face. Maybe her hands. So I'm pretty excited about painting this one up. This one should be a lot of fun. A great looking sword. If I had more time on these, like, these are for a buddy's game, so I'm trying to get them done relatively quickly, but if I had more time on these, I would do, like, some non-metallic metal on that sword and the hilt, the chain that she's got here, even on her armor, you know, because it's got such great, you know, it's got good curves, it's got nice angles on it, you know, very, very easy to do non-metallic metal. And look at how gothic that boot looks like. Look at that. That's a cool gothic boot. So this is a good one. While she's showing a little, like, this one isn't too bad either, this great archer. I mean, she's got, like, the low-cut shirt on, but she's not, like, super chesty. Got some really cool arrows. So, yeah, looking forward to painting this one up, too. Really interesting. Look at that knife. That's a cool knife. Kind of reminds me of Horizon Zero Dawn. This one's just weird. Kind of wish her face wasn't covered by a weird mask, but crazy looking whip girl. Has a skull on the end of her spear. Very tribal looking. This is another one that kind of reminds me of Horizon too, because the spear's got some spines on it, and she's kind of in skins and this weird, crazy looking mask. Anyway. And then this guy should be a ton of fun. He's dual wielding axes. Which are attached to each other. I think that's just crazy. This is another guy that I saw and I was like, oh, be cool to do some cool non-metallic metal on the axes and such, but again, I gotta get him done some using all metals on him. He's even got like little lanterns on his arm there. He's got one here. It's a very interesting model. I almost want to look up and see what other people have painted him like, because these almost look like teeth. They look like molars around here, and I'm wondering if that's what they are, and that would be really, really creepy, because you almost see the gum line around here. Oh, that's really creepy. I wonder if that's what that is. What if he's got teeth on his armor? I know, I think I might. I'm gonna have to ask Tim. Tim, are these teeth? This guy's kinda cool. It looks like he's got like the Phoenix's hands on his armor. With this really cool lion shield. Looks like he's got some fur or feathers all over. And this nasty looking cleaver. Yeah, that's creepy looking. Once again, wearing a mask. And then we've got giant sword girl with pistol. And once again, it looks like teeth for the armor. That's really weird. But here's where we're going. You know, large tracts of land right there. Masked again. Great hair. I like the hair. The pistol looks cool. Once again, if I was doing non-metallic metal, got some cool little designs right here. So, and then you've got the other lion, which I'm going to do a little bit differently than the one that I painted up before. The other one was like the giant Giga Lion. This is like the smaller version. So, still has hands for front paws. Still pretty creepy. I think I'm going to do him more white than regular lion color. That tan was really cool. And I don't know. I might try and recreate it. Then I'm going to switch back to my other camera here, because either that or you will not see it. Oops, that's the underlay. There we go. We also have this horribly weird looking tree with all these little berries on it that also have... Like there's arms coming out from the limbs. There's faces down here. There are skulls in the trees. There's lanterns and chains and pottery. There's a shield. Anything else that's on there? I think that's a scabbard. I'm losing those berries. And a buddy of mine says, "Oh, you should do this like a blood tree." And I'm like, "What the heck is a blood tree, and how do you know about it?" And he says, "Oh yeah, the blood tree, when the sap leaks out of it, it's a dark red color, so it looks like blood." And there's a really great, like I was actually gonna fill this crack in with a little bit of green stuff. But now I'm thinking about it, I'm like, oh, that crack right there would be really cool to have this sap running out. And of course, you know, like the little things that these berries are hanging on with, like intestines, so I'm definitely going to do. These are going to be more fleshy looking, more blues and purple fleshy, than have like a pink intestine looking thing with that they're hanging on. I've got these great skulls, all these chains. Almost thought about doing the tree white, but then having that red Icarus sap running out of it. Almost kind of like the heart tree from Game of Thrones. And finally, and I'm not going to grab this because he's too far away. But I have the giant dragon for that as well. He's monstrous. His rib cage is opened up so you can see the heart inside of him. And that should be fun to paint too. Yeah, looking forward to doing those. Yeah, the Dragon King. Yep. Alright, now that those eyes are dry, let's grab a little of this Flash Gets Yellow here. See, the secret here is I talk. And let stuff dry. I show you stuff that I'm going to be working on in the future. And that's my secret, folks. So they go, oh, everything is dry. I can go back and keep painting now. So a little bit of this Flash Gets Yellow. And I'm going to create these little flesh holes up in here. So, hard to see that. Yeah, it's there. Ding 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 ding. That's right. Alright. Now, just for funsies. Take a little of this purple tone from Army Painter. maybe just a drop of this. Don't need a whole lot because we're just going to go over. Section right here. Create a little ickiness around these little bumps here. I'm just going to reinforce that purple on the sides of his face here a little bit. See what's around the eyes here. Help blend that blue and purple in a little bit. Shining up the lips here. Let's do the teeth. I'm gonna use a little bit of this light sand leather highlight from AK Interactive here. Don't need a whole lot. Some matte white from Army Painter. Thank you. That looks pretty good. I'll show the close-up here in just a second. Oh, let's get his claws actually on his hands. Maybe I want to do that color. Yeah, I think I want to do those different. I'm gonna do them darker. Alright, well then we'll take a little bit of this matte white. Mix it in with our fleshy, sandy color here. Get a good momentum. Just a little bit of white. You guys have any idea how badly I want to turn this guy into the clown from Spawn? The Violator. This face would be perfect for that. Alright, well, I'll wait for that to dry. Let's give a quick shout out to the folks that are on tonight. Who do we got? Holy cow, we got quite a few people watching. Academy Impossible, Alien Gathering, Grafmau, It's the Fritz, It's Sama, Kazips06, Lori Pub, Midsoon, Rogue Girl, Sterling2112, Violets TV, and We Love Marbles. Hey, thanks everybody for watching tonight. I really appreciate it. It means the world to me, really does. You guys are awesome. Oh, God. Just killed my first spider of spring. It's time to spray the baseboards of the basement for critters. Alright, so I'm going to show you guys what he looks like. There's his face. Could you imagine him with a little bit of like white clown makeup on now? Oh, jeez. I almost want to do it, but I'm not going to. I don't think Tim would approve. He might think it's funny, but this is the. Let's see if I can. Oh, no, it's not going to let me. I gotta go to this. There's the human body on its angler. Come here, help me, help me, help me. So there's that. grab some aged bone and some... maybe not. Hold on. Think. The tree just fell. We're okay. We're all right. Grab a little bit of Shabti bone here. I think this is going to work well. Grab my beat up number one brush here. That was a good choice. Glad I grabbed the Ushabti bone. Because then I can mix in a little bit of white or something like that to it. You can highlight that up. more control with this one too. Sometimes you gotta pick it up and come at it from a different angle. All right, I think we are gonna call it there. We got about 2 minutes left here. We got a pretty good paint night. Another 2 hours into him. That would be, let's see, what do we got on this guy so far? 4 hours, 4 to 6 hours, I think, already on the giant Spidertaur. So not too bad at all. Hey, so we'll be back again on Wednesday at 8 o'clock Central Time. I hope you all had a great time watching. Sterling, thank you so much for popping in. Excuse me, Quick Venom, I know, was here as well as one of my moderators. Appreciate it. So we'll be back on Wednesday. Thank you all for watching. And as always, happy painting, folks. Bye.